Smoke from those record-setting wildfires in Canada continues to move into the U.S., posing a threat not only to our lungs and hearts, but our skin, which is interesting. So here to explain, Dr. Shadi Kharoch, the Director of Dermatology for Community Health Program at Mass General Hospital. Dr. Kharoch, thanks for joining us.
Good to be here. Thank you.
So as you know, Doctor, this smoke could impact our air quality on and off throughout the weekend. So why does that matter to a dermatologist?
Well, I think it matters to all of us doctors here because the skin is really the external view screen for what's going on inside of the body, not just the damage that is happening on the skin itself. So we know, for example, that there's a relationship between eczema and asthma. And we've seen a lot of people having asthma flares because of the smoke and smog damaging the lungs. And that activates the immune system and can cause flares in people that have skin sensitivities. Additionally, there are damaging compounds in smoke and smog that can actually deposit on the skin barrier, causing breakdown of the protective barrier of the skin and causing irritation to eczema spots. And we've actually seen research that during periods of wildfires, for example, in California over the last few years, there were record numbers of upticks in visits for eczema to the doctor.
So for people who have a history of things like eczema or sensitive skin, what can they do to protect themselves?
Well, it's going to be a challenge, but I think that it's important to protect the areas of the skin that are exposed if we go outside. For example, with masks, sunglasses, dermatologists are always, you know, promoting covering the skin. And then also with mineral-based sunscreens. Now, there are two types of sunscreens, one that have chemical filters, and those are the big long names that you might see when you flip the bottle over and read the ingredients. And then there are mineral sunscreens that are ones that contain active ingredients like zinc, titanium, iron oxide, which are the short terms, you know, the short words when you read the ingredients. And those are actually better at protecting the skin and creating a protective barrier against pollution. But really the best thing possible is avoidance. You know, if it's possible to avoid areas like urban settings or areas where there's going to be a lot of smog and smoke, that's great. And then also to keep windows closed. And we also recommend air filters, you know, air purifying filters in the home if possible.
All right, doctor, thanks so much for your time. We appreciate it.